Yeah.
I'm the Human Skab, and you listen to WZBC, or I'll come to your house and kill you.
Like the Screaming Demons, one of the lead cuts from Human Skab's second cassette release, Thunder Chips and Saddlebags, the cassette that WZBC was lucky enough to receive in the mail sometime earlier this year, and that happens to be the first song I ever heard from Human Skab, a song that made me wonder instantly, what exactly was it that I was hearing? Was it really a 10-year-old kid with that warped of a mind, or just a 10-year-old kid with an older brother helping him every step of the way, making kind of a silly tape? I was so curious about these matters that I tried to telephone the Human Skab at his residence in Elma, Washington, and my first conversations were with his parents. I think they go quite a ways in explaining some of these questions that I was asking myself.
Hello?
Hello, I'd like to speak to Human Skab, please.
He's at school. This is Skab Dad.
Okay, what do you think would be a good time to call?
Well, I really don't know because, see, I go to work in the afternoon. I don't know exactly what they do while I'm at work.
Not having much luck with Skab Dad, I decided to give another call a couple hours later and see if I'd have any luck then reaching Human Skab. Then I talked to his mother.
Hello?
Hi, is Human Skab home?
Oh, are you that guy from Boston?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, you know, Human Skab isn't here. My husband didn't know that he had a soccer game, so he won't be home till probably 7.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty late in Boston. I mean, his game starts at 5:30, 6:30, I hate for you to waste your money calling up and not getting anybody. Maybe you shouldn't try till 8. Yeah, it's okay, because 8 o'clock is... He's still awake.
After talking to those two, I was beginning to wonder if the birth certificate didn't say Human Skab on it. But sure enough, 8 o'clock rolled around, and I made yet one more call to the Human Skab residence, talked to the final member of Human Skab's immediate family that's able to speak, and it was then that I found out what his christened name really was.
Hello?
Hello, Human Skab?
Hello?
Is this the Human Skab?
Yeah. Hey, Travis! No, this ain't Human Skab, except he's my brother. Hey, Travis! Human Skab! Somebody's on the phone! Hello?
Hello, is this Human Skab?
Yeah.
How you doing?
Fine.
Did you win your soccer game?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah, 11-0.
You killed him?
Uh-huh.
Well, my name's John. How you doing?
Fine.
I work at a radio station that you sent your tape to. And your tape was number one at our station in February.
Mm. Mm-hmm. I'm quite awesome. I'm from Boston.
Understandably, at this point in the interview, I was beginning to get a little worried that Human Skab would turn out to be slightly more reserved than one would expect after hearing such utterances on his cassette as this.
Touch your eyeballs and push for a long time and it burns. Why don't you do it right now and try it out, people out there in the world? You should listen to my music, especially you that steal the tapes. You already have a chance. You are radio people, and you can listen anyway, you stupid freaks. I should punch the lights out of you. I should throw you into space and make you be a constellation.
But as it turns out, once things got rolling, Human Skab became the Human Skab that we all know and love from his music. And we were able to find out a few interesting things about his tape. Most importantly, exactly how much help he had. Is that brother, was that Stan that I was just talking to?
Ashton.
Do you have a brother called Stan?
No.
You know that song about the broken window?
Yeah.
Don't you talk about your brother Stan? He was so scared.
No, I say Ashton.
Oh. Is that your only brother?
Yeah, but I have a sister named Cheyenne. And my friend Pat West, and a friend Mike Bull is that's in it.
How old are they?
One's 9, one's 11.
So that's the oldest person in the tape is 11 years old?
What?
The oldest person in the tape is 11 years old?
Yeah, that's me.
Oh, you're 11?
Yeah, now I'm 11.
Uh-huh.
I'm older than Pat, and he's 11, too. I turned 11 June 24th. Wait a minute.
Mom, will you please leave me alone? He's here, too.
My mom keeps saying that Pat didn't write any of, didn't help any of throwing rocks at windows, and he did.
What did he do on throwing rocks at windows?
The very first part, before, and then the old lady came out of her house. And then that one I made up.
Uh-huh. You made up all the part about then she scolded us and all that stuff?
Mm-hmm.
So, what made you decide to make a tape?
Frank talked me into it.
Which one?
The first one. And then I wanted to do the next one.
So you've made two tapes?
Yeah.
Is one of them called Thunder Chips and Saddlebags or something like that?
Yeah, Thunder Hips and Saddlebags is the second one.
Did you give a name to the first one?
Scabby Nanny.
Scabby Nanny. They both have different stuff on it, right?
Yeah.
Which one is the one that has We Need to Destroy the Soviet Union and all that stuff?
Thunder Hips and Saddlebags.
Uh-huh. And who did you mail them to?
Lots of people. I just got 4 letters today. I get them every day.
How did you decide where to mail your tapes? Like, how did you find out about the radio stations and stuff?
Oh, Frank did that.
Who's he?
He's my cousin. He was a DJ or something at Chaos.
Mm-hmm.
At the Olympia, Edgerton State College.
Did he have anything to do with making the tapes?
Sometimes he played the, music, and on Destroy the Soviet Union, we used his 4-track.
Uh-huh. So, was it his idea, did he tell you, like, some of the words or anything like that, or do you make up all your own words to say?
I made up the Soviet Union as I went along.
Did you make up all the words on the tape, or did he tell you some of them?
He didn't tell me any. Me and my friend, Pat, does most of them.
Mm-hmm.
Pat's the word man.
And what are you? The singer.
Yeah.
When you were staggering out in the middle of the road?
Yeah, Jason staggering around.
Who made up the words to that?
Mm-hmm.
And what gave you that idea?
Me and Pat were in the garage getting all the cans to turn in.
Uh-huh.
And we found 2 beers that weren't empty. So that gave me that idea.
So you figured the guy got hit by a car before he got a chance to drink his last 2 beers?
I don't know.
What kind of music do you listen to?
Classic rock.
Like what?
Rockin' Robin, Johnny B. Good, those kind.
Mm-hmm. Do you have those records?
My aunt does. My aunt has a whole stack full of 45s.
So, are those pretty much your inspiration?
I don't know what is. Real music is.
You know that song about, we're still mining the radiation?
Mm-hmm.
And you use one of those toy guns as an instrument in there, right?
Yeah.
Are you the one playing that gun?
Yeah. I had an Uzi in one hand and an M16 in the other hand. Yeah, but we have a nuke plant in Elma.
Did it kill anybody? Is it like 3 Mile Island or something?
What?
Like 3 Mile Island?
Sorry, I can't hear you.
You know what 3 Mile Island is?
No.
Well, how does it feel to be the first kid to hit the radio?
I don't know.
You gonna make another tape?
I probably will. I already named it.
Bossy Baby.
Do you have anything recorded for it yet?
No. Except I have one song.
You wrote it, but you didn't record it yet?
Mm-hmm. We don't have a mic. We have to get a mic.
Uh-huh.
So I go to my friend Pat's house. She has a mic, and we record some, but not all the time. Because somebody has to stand there and hold the record button because it pops out.
Well, thanks a lot, Scab. Anything else you want to say to the listeners in Boston?
Are they listening right now?
No, but they will be. I'll play this over the air.
Okay, I don't know. Someday I'm going to run in the Boston Marathon.
This is Human Skab. Oh, I forgot the name. Okay, ZBZ. Okay. ZBC. WZBC. WZBC. Okay.
Yeah. I'm Human Skab, and you listen to ZBC, or I'll come to your house and kill you.
Dead, dead, everybody dead, 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 dead.